So we have in hand the lineup for the 2020 Sundance Film Festival, and the directors of the festival are here with us in studio. We're going to bring you a taste of what to expect over more than 100 new movies that'll be premiering in Park City this January. John Cooper, Kim Utani, when you're trying to define what a Sundance movie is in your heads to choose something, is there something you're looking for when selecting?
This is the question we get all the time.
We don't have an answer.
Yeah, but I think, you know, I think that what we see in the program this year, a lot of those Sundance movies are defined as things that are fresh, that come from a very particular point of view, that have an artistic vision that might be fresh.
And I think, too, what we're sensing is a lot of the independent films are almost separating even more and more from the Hollywood films. They're just really distinct in a real independent way.
Looking at the lineup this year, you've got Oscar winners, you know, right, showing up in independent films.
I think they're drawn to parts that they maybe don't usually get, and just more maybe interesting work than they get in their other career lives, and I think it's exciting for them.
I mean, I was sort of starting with the big names because those are the ones that a lot of people look to from the sidelines to be kind of excited about what's going on there.
Right.
But the discoveries are probably the people no one has heard from before, and you're in the business of promoting or giving their first step. Who are you sort of excited about internally?
I'm excited about Jenisca Bravo. She just has a really clear, interesting voice. Who else are we excited about?
I'm excited about Lee Isaac Chung, who he's been around for a while. He's made films that have played the festival circuit, but this new film of his, Minari, I think is his big breakout film.
We have lots of returning, you know, alumni this year that had passed lives at Sundance, and that it really, I think, it says a lot about the independent film community. Sometimes I want to call it a movement, but it feels almost more community than movement. It's like, so that's fun for us too when people come back.
To what extent do you even see trends in the movies that are coming your way?
We've hit on some, just the returning alumni and the more celebrated star power. Mm-hmm. But also there's some other notions about family, especially family set in America. We're seeing all different views of American life, which I think is new. It's coming from the directors that are coming up too, because they're coming from all over parts of our world. And I think that's something that's giving a lot of life to the independent film world.
Kim, what kind of trends are you seeing?
Well, this year I felt like we saw a lot about the power and the passion of youth. I think one of the films I can think of is Us Kids, which deals with the teenage survivors of the Parkland shooting. There's also this extraordinary doc called Boys State. It deals very directly with youth and politics, and also feels very timely this year.
Mm-hmm. I think a lot of times first-time filmmakers look at coming-of-age stories. It's almost what they know. Mm-hmm. But this is about the responsibility of the new generation, basically, being engaged, being political, being activist. And of course, documentary is a medium that's becoming a tool and and a megaphone for those kind of causes too now.
Now the trend too is not to only make the documentary, but come up with a plan to create more impact with those documentaries out in the world, more and more. That's what the Institute is even dealing a lot with.
Yeah, so with this being your final year, do you have any specific goals kind of going into the 2020 festival?
I don't want any glitch in the good work that Sundance does because I'm leaving. I think it can be seamless. I think it might take a little like concentration more than I would, because Kim and I are such a shorthand that you have to maybe stop and think about some things, which I don't think is such a bad thing for festivals to do as well. You might take a look at the categories, because when I took over as director, we changed the categories a lot to match what the artists were doing, and it was time for that. So probably a little of that, maybe. I'm not sure where it's going to lead us. But, yeah.
Well, thank you both for coming in. We'll be covering the Sundance Film Festival. We'll send a full army of reporters and critics to to Park City to bring you news of all of these films. So stay tuned to Variety for coverage throughout the entire festival.